Not too long from now, Ethereum will get another update. It's called Constantinople and will bring some much needed upgrades to improve the performance of the Ethereum blockchain and will also address the problems related to the difficulty bomb and miner rewards. The update is rather intensive and will break backwards compatibility, meaning that it will come into existence with a hard fork. But no worries, we don't expect Ethereum to actually split into a new currency. Let's go over the changes in Constantinople and let's start with the performance improvements. This is an important area for Ethereum because it's facing a lot of competition from other platforms that have better performance. To address this, developers are improving the Ethereum virtual machine, the engine that executes the code of smart contracts. The first improvement is EIP-145, which adds bitwise shifting instructions to the EVM. Bitwise shifting is the process of moving the bits of a number to the left or right. With this new instruction, these operations will use 10 times less gas, meaning that running certain smart contracts will actually get cheaper. Oh, and by the way, EIP stands for Ethereum Improvement Proposal. Every member of the community can write such a proposal and submit it for review. If a majority of people agrees with the proposal, it gets accepted and implemented. Next up is EIP-1052, which introduces a new operation that allows smart contracts to verify the code of another contract more efficiently. Previously, this verification would require you to grab the code of that other contract and then verifying it. This new operation, however, returns a hash of the code, allowing you to check that instead. The hash of a contract is like a fingerprint. It uniquely identifies the code and cannot be forged. So EIP-145 and 1052 will make the EVM more efficient and thus make it cheaper for people to run their smart contracts on the Ethereum network. Besides performance improvements, there's also EIP-1014 that will add state channels to Ethereum. These can be compared to Bitcoin's Lightning Network and allow certain transactions to be settled away from the main blockchain. You can learn all about that in this video right here. It can greatly improve the performance and throughput of Ethereum. And then we get to a proposal that might seem a bit weird. EIP-1234 is about delaying the difficulty bomb and reducing the block reward. So what's the difficulty bomb and why would we want to reduce the block reward? Let's start with the block reward. Up until now, miners on the Ethereum network get 3 Ether when they mine a new block. This is called the block reward. A new block is created roughly every 15 seconds, meaning that every day there are 5 to 6,000 new blocks added. With a block reward of 3 Ether, that results in 15 to 18,000 new Ether being added to the total supply. And this can become a big issue, because the ever-growing supply of Ether puts the price under pressure. You see, if something is scarce, it increases in value, but if something is available in abundance, it decreases. In case of a cryptocurrency, it can push people towards selling their coins because they decrease in value. So reducing the issuance of new coins will effectively reduce the inflation of Ether and will probably drive the price of Ether back up. It will also attract new investors because they know that the value will be more stable. So reducing the block reward makes a lot of sense. Bitcoin has a similar but completely automated mechanism where the issuance is halved every 210,000 block, again trying to make the resource more scarce. Some people suggested to reduce the issuance even further to 1 Ether. While it would likely push the price even higher, miners would earn a lot less. And that's a potential issue because the network needs the miners to secure the platform. If a lot of miners stop mining Ethereum, it could weaken the network and make it vulnerable to attacks. So instead, a more conservative reduction in block reward was chosen in the hope that most miners will stick around. EIP-1234 also wants to reduce the difficulty bomb. So what's that all about? Well, it has to do with Ethereum's plan to move away from the proof-of-work algorithm and adopt proof-of-stake. You can learn more about proof-of-stake and why it's so important in this video right here. But the brief summary is this. Right now, miners are needed to process transactions and create new blocks. As a compensation for their hard work, they receive the block reward. With proof of stake, however, miners become obsolete, meaning that they'll lose their revenue. So when Ethereum finally switches to proof of stake, miners can choose to not adopt the new update and instead keep the old version running. It would be a true hard fork where the community is torn apart, each going their own direction. This happened to Ethereum in the past when it was forked into Ethereum Classic. The developers, however, are keen to keep this from happening again, and so they added the difficulty bomb into the protocol. It's a special mechanism that makes mining a new block exponentially more difficult over time, until at some point it becomes impossible, effectively freezing the entire network. This is also called the Ethereum Ice Age, and it was first added on September 7th, 2015. The difficulty bomb accomplishes two things. First, it puts pressure on the developers of Ethereum to come up with an update for the protocol because they obviously don't want it to go into an ice age. And secondly, it forces miners to adopt new updates because otherwise they'll end up with a blockchain that can't make them any money. In other words, they can't stick with a network that is increasingly becoming slower. The difficulty bomb is a great idea, but not perfect. After the original introduction in 2015, the plan was to make the network almost unusable by the end of 2016. The idea being that the switch to proof of stake would have been made by that time. But obviously, that did not happen. Developers don't want to rush the Casper update, the one where they'll introduce and adopt proof of stake. They want to make sure that the new protocol is as safe as the old one. So the difficulty bomb has been delayed a few times, including now with the Constantinople update. It's still there, waiting to put pressure on developers and miners, but for now, it is diffused, giving everyone a bit more time. So that was a bird's eye view of Ethereum's upcoming update. It's planned to be released at the end of October, but that might still be postponed. That was it for this video. If you liked it, hit the thumbs up button and consider getting subscribed. And as always, thank you very much for watching.